Did you know that n8n offers some powerful AI features out of the box? Today, we'll be unpacking one of the most versatile AI nodes in n8n, the Basic LLM Chain. And trust me, your workflows are about to get a whole lot smarter. So let's get started. Go ahead and create a new workflow, give it a name. I'll just call mine Basic LLM Chain Tutorial. After that, click on Add First Step and let's add the trigger manually node. After that, add a new node and this time go to Advanced AI and click on the Basic LLM Chain. First, let's go back to the canvas to see what this node looks like. n8n automatically added this chat node. We will not use the chat node in this video, but we will use it in the next video where we will build an AI chatbot. The Basic LLM Chain takes an AI model as input. Therefore, let's add an AI model by clicking on Add Node. And here you will see a list of available AI models that you can use. Now, if you wanted to, you can use Anthropic's Claude models, or you can add the OpenAI GPT models, but these models do cost money, and I do want you to be able to follow along with this tutorial for free. Therefore, I'll be using the Groq chat model. Once you've done this, we need to assign credentials to the Groq chat model. So click on this dropdown, click on Create New Credential, and here we need to provide a Groq API key. To get a Groq API key, go to groq.com, go to Developers, and click on Start Building. Or you could just go to console.groq.com. You will need to sign in with an account, and it is free to do so. Click on Create API key. Give your key a name, like n8n, and click on Submit. Then copy this key and add it to the API key field. Click on Save, and if everything was done correctly, you should see this green connection tested successfully message. Close this pop-up, and in the model list, go ahead and select the Llama 3.1 70 billion parameter model, like so. That is all we have to do to set up our LLM model. Let's go back to the canvas and let's open up the Basic LLM chain again. If we simply run this chain, nothing will happen as we haven't specified a prompt. A prompt is simply the instruction or the question to the model. If we click on the prompt dropdown, we can grab the prompt from a previous node or we can define our own prompt below. Let's actually select this Define Below option. Now we can enter our question or instruction to the model. I'll simply enter hello there and we can now run test step. And look at that, this time we get a response back from our AI model. We do get some other important output for the LLM node as well. If we click on logs, we can see some important information about this inference call, like the time it took to get a response, the execution time, as well as the amount of tokens that were used. And these can be very useful for determining the cost of this call. Also, if you click on this info button, you can see the breakdown of the tokens used in our prompt, as well as the response from the AI model. Let's go back to output. We can also add messages to our model by clicking on Add Prompt. In this dropdown, we have an option of selecting an AI message, a system message, or a user message. The system message is very commonly used to provide instructions to the model. As an example, we can use this to provide a personality and a role to the model. Like, I'm actually going to expand this box to make it a bit more visible, and I'm going to enter, "You are a pirate called John." And let's also add something silly like include emojis in your responses. You can close this pop-up. And now when we test this, our AI model is definitely responding like a pirate and it's included emojis as well. Of course, we can also add other messages like AI messages or user messages to add one or multi-shot prompts, but we won't do it in this presentation. Instead, I want to move on to some of the more important use cases of Basic LLM chains. Instead of hard coding the prompt like we are doing here, we could grab values from one of the previous nodes and add it to this field, which is perfectly fine. But I do want to show you what this take from previous node automatically option does. With this option, the previous node needs to output a variable called chat input. Let's see how that works. Let's go back to the canvas. Now this node here is not able to provide any sort of output. So I'm going to add a set node in between these two nodes like so. And these set nodes can actually be very useful for creating test data while building out a workflow. Let's add a new field and we know we need to call it chat input, like so. And for the value, let's enter, why is the sky blue? Let's go back to the canvas. Let's test this entire workflow. And we can see that this flow was executed successfully. And this node automatically grabbed this value because we called it chat input, and it generated a response for us. And as I mentioned earlier, you can definitely switch this to define below and grab the value from the left and drop it into this field. This will work perfectly fine as well, as you can see here. Now let's move on to a few real-world use cases for using these LLM chains. And a very popular use case is sentiment analysis. For instance, let's say we wanted to build a sentiment analysis workflow. For example, this workflow could receive a review for a product or service, and we simply wanted the LLM to determine if the review was positive, negative, or neutral, and then we'll do something with that decision. The first thing we can do is to pass in a review as input. Let's write something like, the food was great. So I'll run this step, and let's go back to the basic LLM chain, and let's change the system prompt to something like, your role is to determine if a review is positive, negative, or neutral. Let's close this pop-up. We can now run this node, and the LLM determined that the review was indeed positive. But this output is actually not very useful, because it is giving us a whole description and reasoning for why it's determined the review to be positive. In the real world, we would want this response to only contain the word positive, negative, or neutral. Now, we could obviously just add that instruction to the system message to tell the LLM to only respond with the word positive, negative, or neutral. But there will always be the risk that the model will not follow the instruction exactly, or perhaps return the words with uppercase letters or only lowercase letters, and that inconsistency could be a problem. So in order to ensure that the model will output the response in a consistent way, we can enable the require specific output format. We now get this message saying that we need to connect an output parser. Therefore, go back to the canvas, and you will now notice that we can attach an output parser. So go ahead and click on output parser and add the structured output parser. n8n is kind enough to give us an example of what the structure looks like. But I'm actually going to change the schema type to define below. We can also expand this view to make it a little bit more readable. And this might seem super complicated, but it's really not. You can use ChatGPT or Claude to assist you with generating this schema. In fact, let's do that now. We can enter something like, create a JSON schema with one object called sentiment and with three possible values, positive, negative, or neutral. And what we can also do is copy this example schema and pass it in as well. So I'll say something like example schema, and let's pass all of that in. We can go ahead and run this, and this is fine to me. We've got one property called sentiment, which is of type string, and for the enum value, we only have positive, negative, and neutral. And of course, the sentiment property is required. I'll copy this and paste it into n8n. We can now close this pop-up. We can go back to the canvas and let's run this workflow. Now let's have a look at what we got back from the LLM chain. And we can see in the output that the sentiment was returned as positive. What's really important is if we open up JSON, we can see that the response was actually returned as a JSON schema. And this property will always be consistent, and we know what the possible values could be. And this is actually more powerful than you might think. And let me show you a few ways in how this can be used outside and within your workflows. A very common use case is to expose these LLM chains through API endpoints or webhooks. And this will allow developers to call your workflow from outside of n8n. So let's assume you have this website or app that allows users to submit reviews, and you wanted some AI intelligence to determine if the review was positive or negative, and then do something with that result. So to expose this workflow as an API, we can simply remove these two nodes. Let's add a new node, and let's add the webhook call. We can change the method from get to post. Let's change the path to something like sentiment. And let's go back to the canvas and let's connect this webhook to our LLM chain. Let's first get some data into this node by clicking on run. We can now copy this endpoint and we can test it from something like Postman. So in Postman, I'll add a new tab. I'll paste in that URL. We can change it from get to post, and in the body, I'll change it to raw, and we can enter some payload using curly braces, is passing a property called review, and for the review value, I'll pass in something like the hotel was terrible. Let's send this, and back in n8n, we can see the output, and here we can see the body with the review and with the review value. Now let's go back to the canvas within the basic LLM chain. Let's reassign this text value to the review value that we received from the webhook call. Great. Now let's test this out. Let's click on test workflow. We can run this again. And in n8n, if I open up the LLM node, we can see that the sentiment was performed on that review. Now at the moment, the response from the webhook isn't very useful, as it's simply telling us that the workflow started. We can fix that by adding another node at the end of the workflow. We can search for respond to webhook, and what we want to do is pass back the sentiment value. So to do this, let's change respond with to JSON. I'll switch over to expression. I'll expand this so it's a bit more readable. Let's change this property to sentiment. Of course, you can call it whatever you want, but for the value, I want to grab the sentiment value that came back from the LLM node, like so. Here we can see a preview of what the response would look like. We can now close this pop-up. We can go back to the canvas. Let's click on test workflow. Let's change the review to something positive, like the hotel was great. We can now run this, and we will receive an error at this point. But this is perfectly fine. If you add a respond to webhook to your canvas, you do need to change the webhook node itself. And within this webhook, you need to change respond to using respond to webhook node. If we test this again, let's run this. We do get this JSON response back with the word positive. Moving on from webhooks, we can also use LLM chains to enrich data. So let's say that instead of calling a webhook, we expose a form from n8n where users can capture their name and the review. And we then want to store the original name and review along with the sentiment in an Airtable. Let's build out that example. Let's start by adding a form. So I'll add an n8n form trigger. Let's give the form a name like review. For the title, I'll call it review form. For the description, I'll enter something like leave your review here. For the first field, let's enter a label like name, which is of field type text. And for the placeholder, let's enter your name here. And we can make this a required field. We can add another field called review, which is of type text area, and a placeholder of enter your review here, which is also a required field. Let's test this out, and for the name, I'll enter Leon, and for the review, let's enter this was a lot of fun. Let's submit this, and back in n8n, we can see that we received those values. We can now go back to the canvas and attach this form to the basic LLM chain. We can open the LLM chain, and let's replace this text value with the review from the form. And if I now test this chain, we do get our sentiment value back. So now that we have the review, the customer's name, and the sentiment, we can actually add a merge node to this canvas, like so, and we can change the mode to combine and combine by position with two inputs. So if we go back to the canvas, we can now attach the response from the LLM chain to input 2, and we can add the fields from the original form to input 1. So if we now test this workflow, let's call the name John with a review of the food sucked. Let's run this. And if we look at the contents of the merge node, we can now see our name, the review, as well as the sentiment output. We can take this even further by adding something like an if node or a switch node, which we had a look at in one of the previous videos. So here we can say that if the sentiment contains a value of positive, I'll actually rename this to the positive root, or we can add another routing rule where we can also add the sentiment with a value of negative. Let's rename the output to negative, and I'll add one more routing rule for the value neutral. Let's also rename this output to neutral. And if we go back to the canvas, we can now route this information to different paths depending on whether the sentiment was positive, negative, or neutral. In fact, let's run this workflow. For the name, I'll just enter Sam. For the review, let's enter This tutorial helped a lot. Let's submit the form. Let's have a look at the switch node. And here we can see that our message was routed down the positive path with nothing in the negative or neutral paths. So what we can do now is write these reviews to different Airtable tables depending on the sentiment. As an example, here I've created three tables in Airtable. One for the positive reviews, the negative reviews, and the neutral reviews. So we want to add entries to these tables depending on the sentiment of the review. I've already created a video where I show you how to add Airtable to n8n, so if you do want to follow along, then I'll link to that video in the description and you should see a card popping up right now. So back in n8n, let's add a new node to the positive route. Let's look for Airtable, and for the action, let's select create a record. Go ahead and select your Airtable credentials. Select your Airtable base, which I called reviews. Now for the table, I'm going to select the positive table. Then I'll grab the name from the previous node. I'll also grab the review, and that should be all of it. Let's go back to the canvas, and we can simply duplicate this node by right-clicking the node. Let's click on duplicate. Let's connect the negative route to this Airtable node. Also, let's open up this Airtable node. Let's change the table from positive to negative. Let's go back to the canvas. Let's duplicate this node one more time. Let's attach the neutral route to this node. Let's open up this node and change the table to neutral. And that's actually all we have to do to create this workflow. Let's test this out. So first, let's create a positive review. Let's enter, the room was clean and comfortable. Let's submit this. We can see in the positive table that the review was added successfully. Let's try a negative review. So for the name, I'll enter Sam. For the review, let's enter, the food was cold and terrible. Okay, let's submit this. And look at that. The negative route was indeed followed. And if we go back to Airtable, let's click on negative. And here we can see that review. And lastly, let's try the neutral branch. Let's enter max. And for the review, let's enter I don't really care. And indeed, this went down the neutral path. And looking at Airtable, our review was added. If you enjoyed this video, then please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more n8n content. Also, check out these other n8n videos over here. I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.